It's a nice car.
Does it run?
Like a top.
Check her out under the hood.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, a little 289.
302.
Really?
Later model serpentine belt setup, electronic ignition, four-barrel carb. There's nothing to hide.
Hell. Nothing to hide, sir.
Woo!
Yeah, dude.
What happened in there?
What are you talking about?
It smells like a burnt baby's diaper in there.
My eyes watering.
I didn't smell anything. Did you smell something?
Open the doors.
How can you not smell that?
Stick your hand in there and get you a whiff of that.
You smelled his aftershave. Oh, God.
Yes, who's the opening?
Okay,
shut
it. Shut it.
Woo-hoo. You guys didn't smell this?
Well, the windows were down.
I've never even sat in this thing.
It's horrible.
How did it get in the trailer?
The man offered to put it up for us.
For a reason. There's something that died in this car. We can't sell it if it smells like this.
It's a little gamey, but nothing a little airing out.
Yes.
And a little cleanup won't fix.
A little cleanup won't.
How much was it?
We paid $10,000.
So another $3,000 or $4,000 in it, what do you think we'll get? Think we can get in the 20s?
I think we can get close to mid-20s.
I think you're right.
A lot of American buyers love these old cars, but hate the factory suspension. So if we throw $3,000 or $4,000 at her to add coilovers for a smoother, more enjoyable ride, some sparkling new tires, and the deepest, shiniest detail job, then we should easily be able to attract someone looking for that classic cruiser.
It smells rancid, guys.
Rancid.
This should be a quick flip, and I say should because God knows what that smell is. If it's serious enough that we need to replace some interior components, we could be looking at a lot of time and money spent.